The building was first built in 1888. It was originally a warehouse and shipping, but it's had a long-standing history of community involvement and use in the area. It was transferred as a community centre in 1983 and named after Juanita Nielsen, the local activist. When the redevelopment was starting, the council also had some focus groups with the local community, and it was really important to them to maintain the heritage of the facility. They were really passionate about keeping the facade and the windows, and they made sure that, you know, they had key features also kept inside the facility, such as the rafting, the roof rafters, the void.
Architects Nielsen Murcutt worked with the City of Sydney, centre staff and the community to develop a scheme that retains the fabric of the building, at the same time providing opportunities to include modern facilities.
The community definitely wanted to have Juanita Nielsen and her presence or her remembrance still put into the centre, and so the architects were really clever, I think, in the way that they brought it in with the striped awnings.
The Design Guide for Heritage was a collaboration between the Government Architect New South Wales and the Heritage Council. The Juanita Nielsen case study in Woolloomooloo is one of a series of nine that bring the guide to life. The guide provides practical advice for those who are involved in conserving, maintaining and using our heritage places.
So the architecture and the building obviously itself is absolutely beautiful, but more importantly I think it's about how it's used and the way that the community actually feel at home here and really love it.